Welcome to part two, guys. Just sit back and enjoy the show. And it's just me. And I don't have Brum either.
Our heroes found themselves overlooking miles of rolling farmland, for it seems the water Jack and Jill went up the hill to fetch had magical properties. Despite Jack's broken crown and a possible skull fracture, he and Jill...
Just give me a second, guys.
Spreading joy.
No one knew what the potion would do. After Donkey did a taste test, Shrek chugged the potion, hoping it contained a happily ever after for him and Fiona. Nothing happened, at least at first. But then, in the middle of the rainy night, something unexpected happened. Shrek and Donkey underwent a massive transformation. Shrek was as handsome as a prince, and Donkey his noble steed. Things seemed to be going great as the gang said thanks and goodbye to Little Red for now. But after Shrek drank her potion, Fairy Godmother knew her son, Prince Charming, had a handsome rival for Fiona's affection. So she made sure he was locked away in the deepest, darkest dungeon of a faraway prison where no escape was possible. What Fairy Godmother didn't count on was Shrek's friends finding out about his arrest through a concerned and extremely benevolent third party. So a jailbreak was planned, one that would most certainly test the fellowship of this thing.
All right, listen up! The mice will sneak into the warden's office and get the keys to free the boy!
But they're blind.
Pardon you!
I do good with freaking black and white pictures.
I suggest sneaking quietly and undetected.
This one's a good one. I'm
I'm a sexy bitch.
I love the movies. This one's good with the trees. I don't think I'm supposed to use this, but oh well. You're fucking wrong.
She's Thank you.
Seriously, you can't know it's serious.
Thank you. my house! My insurance covered hoofing, but not sapoofing!
Talk to my lawyer.
Zip it, ladies! The ice must have been cut! No time for coffee breaks!
Welcome to Larry's Discount House of Magic. We're slashing prices. Everything must go. Four things.
screw it. Where are you going, Jimmy?
Thank you. myself with some water.
Just hanging around.
Come on, Wolf, no time to spare. We gotta get back to Far Far Away before the fat lady sings.
How are we gonna get them out of there?
Dressed for bed, but ready for action, Big Bad Wolf.
What? I know, it's hero time.
Yes, well, Wolf, your hero time is full of fabulous prizes and the key to free your pals. But in order to free your pals, you must survive the Staircase of Doom. Get ready for hero time.
Hero time.
You got to be kidding.
Almost done here.
Gingerbread Man brought a little friend. Well, okay, a big friend. Unbeknownst to the crew, Gingerbread Man had whipped up a monstrous cookie creation to help defeat Fairy Godmother. Unfortunately, his weapon of mass destruction turned out to be a mass of doughy devastation.
Help! Knights are attacking the giant cookie but destroying the city! Only you can put out the fire.
We'll take care of this.
Great. I'm going on a porridge break. Meet me at the trucks when you're done.
To put out.
What you're trying to do.
I go for that. Trying to save everyone. What's the point of this one? So we just have to deal with him. Put out the phone. Destroy paddy wagons, have good crumbles burst your balloon until magic beans are
tip. What?
Thank you.
Aw, man. It has something on here.
Oh, it's all good.
Oh. Okay.
See, it's still going.
Yeah, and that thing had to destroy it. Hey, why isn't it going?
Thank you.
is almost invisible.
If Shrek and Fiona didn't kiss before midnight, they would be transformed back into ogre form. But what do you know? Those crazy kids decided to go for the ugly. Love can make you do some pretty strange things. If you don't like awkward kissing scenes, then turn your head.
Oh, I don't get it.
What?
If they don't get to turn back in the ogres, but they kiss their and turn back in the ogres.
No, that's more like it. You're beautiful.
And you are truly handsome, Shrek.
Oh, no! Why?
She looks stupid.
I think my carriage is double parked. You're not going anywhere, you incompetent little toad.
Ribbit!
Hey, Toots! You can't zap my father like that! I will never marry your son.
Looks like we got our happily ever after without your help.
Like a boss battle.
Yeah.
Guess you underestimated us.
The only things I underestimated were trolls and elves. If you want something evil done right, you have to do it your evil son.
Holy godmother. Why her?
Why not?
Run! Not yet. Like a pixie. Why do you say that? Pixie's a fan.
What did I do?
Cheap. Very kind. Oh, come on. I have to start that all over again. Isn't this really wrong? That didn't really help. Those guys are blind.
It's the Yama
tribe.
Thank you.
Thank you. not. Punch it.
Going on his bad side. Yeah.
hit him one more time.
That's
mine.
Yeah, about time we kick this dog to the curb. Or to the tree, whatever.
That's it. I'm sending you straight to the glue factory.
What does that mean? She'll kill us?
Well, you know when they send a crystal glue factory.
Huh? Don't let that thing touch you?
I'm gonna play as Chris.
What?
Wow.
How dare you punish the woman?
I want to take one more strike at it. One. Got her.
What do you know? I can be beaten.
The whole box of tissue.
No first thing, world go round.
What?
Shrek and Fiona got their happily ever after all. Now put down the controller and go outside to play. We're done. Really. It's over. That is all, folks.
Like I care.
We're gonna play our game.
We're gonna play a game.
Well, that's all, folks.
That's all, folks. At least we're done. And how many days?